Hey guys, Akshay here and welcome back to the channel. In this video, I have a web design tutorial for you guys. We are going to be designing this minimal website landing page for a fictional construction company from scratch. So let's get started. So once you open up Adobe XD, you'll be given an option to create an ad board. For this tutorial, I'll be using the standard web size document, that is 1920 by 1080. Let's rename this artboard to homepage. Alright, we're going to start by creating the background for a website. Choose the rectangle icon and create the rectangle the size of the artboard. Deselect the border and I'm going to give it a solid black for now. Now let's drag in the image that we are going to be using for the background. I downloaded these images from Unsplash. I'll leave a link to this in the description below. Now let's align the image to the artboard and scale it down. Make sure to hold down shift when scaling down to make sure it scales evenly. Now right click on this image, go to arrange and send it to back. Then change the fill of the rectangle to a linear gradient. I'm also going to change the angle of the gradient and reduce the fill opacity so that the image behind is slightly visible. What I'm basically doing here is creating a dark overlay for the image so that any text on top of it can be clearly visible. You can increase or decrease the fill opacity here to see how dark you want the overlay to be. Okay, that looks good. Now finally, I'm going to adjust the opacity of the rectangle to say about 75%. Okay, perfect. Now let's select our rectangle and the image to quickly group them. Let's name it background. Now let's start creating the layout for a landing page. I'm quickly going to create two rectangles here. The first one is to display the information about the image, and the second one is to display the page number that we are on, and for the next and previous arrow icons. I'm also going to change the fill of the smaller rectangle to a very light orange. Okay, that's good. Now once that's done, we can start adding in the text for a website. I'm just going to be choosing some random name and location for this house. Also, the font that I'm using is Optima and Avenir Pro. I only use Optima for the large headings, and for rest of the text, I'm going to be using Avenir Pro. Let's also add in a call to action button. I'm going to remove the border of this and also change the border radius to around 5. I'm also going to change the fill to the same orange that we used for the small rectangle. So this call to action button is going to be to see the projects. I'm also going to scale it down a bit and center it within the rectangle. Now let's select these two and group them together. Let's call it CTA. Let me just quickly bring in the layout guides to make sure everything's aligned properly. So it's pretty important you make sure you align everything. I'm also going to align the rectangles to the first guide. Now that everything's perfectly aligned, we can start adding in the content for our rectangles. But before that, I'm going to choose the first rectangle and change the fill to a solid black and also give it a background blur. Now I'm just going to adjust the amount of blur and the brightness to get a very dark semi-transparent look. Now that that's done, we can start adding in the text. I'm going to start by adding the main text, that is Blue Rock House. And for the subtext, I'm just going to be adding some lorem ipsum or some dummy text for now. Also, I think there's a plugin you can install to add lorem ipsum text, but I'm just going to copy and paste it for now. I'm going to scale this down to about 18 and change the line height to 31. I'm also going to change the fill color to a light gray. So now that we are done with the first rectangle, we can start working on the second one. I'm going to start adding the page number that we are currently on. Also, let's change the fill to white. Now let's add in the total number of pages. I'm going to make this text significantly smaller than the current page number. Now I'm just going to align these up really quick. I'm also making sure the space between them is same. Let's also lower the opacity of the total page number to about 40%. Now let's create the arrow icons to move between the pages. So to create this arrow, first I'm going to make a square. Then I'm going to use the pen tool to make the arrow icons using the square as a guide. I'm going to give this a fill of white and I'm also going to scale it down a bit and increase the border to 3. Now press Ctrl D to duplicate this and rotate it. Now let's align this out real quick. I'm going to give a spacing of 40 from each side. Let's also center the numbers as well. Now since we are already on the first page, we cannot go back. So I'm going to reduce the opacity of the first arrow so that it shows it's not clickable. I'm also going to bring down this text a bit to the center. So our landing page design is almost complete. The only thing left out now is to create logo, add the menu, search and social icons. For the logo, I'm just going to type out in-house. So this is the name of our fictional company. I'm also going to align it and give it a spacing of 50 from the top. Now to design the search icon, I'm simply going to create a circle and create a line from underneath the circle. Next, I'll select both of these and increase the border size and unite them. Let's also change the fill to a white. Now for the menu icon, simply create a line. Let's change the fill to a white and then duplicate it twice. Let's also group these three lines together. Then I'm going to bring these icons to the right. Let's open the guides one more time to make sure everything's aligned perfectly. So the menu icon is not properly aligned. Let's fix that. And I'm also going to align this search icon. I'm going to give it a 50 spacing from the right. Now let's add in the social icons. I got these icons from, I think, PNG tree. Not sure, but I downloaded the SVG versions of it so that I can modify them if I need to. So let's scale these down. And change the color to white. I think I'll scale this down a bit more. Okay, that looks good. Now I'm just going to align this. I'm going to give 50 spacing from bottom and align it to the grid, and 30 spacing from the left. All right. Also, there's one last thing that I would like to add to this design, and that's a page indicator. I know we already have a page number to indicate this, but I feel like this adds a bit more to the design visually. So I'm just going to create a rectangle, and then I'm going to use the repeat grid tool to make four of them. And I'm just going to change the color of the first one to the orange, and the rest I'm going to change it to a dark gray and bring down the opacity. So our design is finally complete, and it's time to prototype. Press Ctrl D to duplicate your artboard. I'm going to be making a simple image slider for landing page design. There's a few quick changes to be made to the second artboard, like changing the page number, the page indicator, adding a new background image, and also changing the H1 text that we have for the image. Now this won't work just yet. To get the image sliding effect, you need to copy the image from the second artboard onto the first one and position it above the first artboard's image. Now move the copied image to the right and decrease the opacity. Now that that's done, we can jump into prototype mode and start prototyping. So first, select the arrow from the second artboard and map it to the first one. Also, choose auto animate with ease in out for the duration of 0.8 seconds. Repeat the same process for the first artboard and click on play. So as you can see, we have this smooth image slider animation going on here. I have completed all the four image slides using the same process, and this is what the end results look like. So that's it for this quick web design tutorial. I hope you guys found this tutorial helpful. Consider leaving a thumbs up if you did. I'd greatly appreciate it. And also don't forget to subscribe for more design related content. Hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.